Hello friends, welcome to the VLSI Design course. So today we are going to see our next topic, writing a VHDL code for 4-bit up counter. So in our previous lectures already we have understood the design of a 4-bit counter using synchronous method, using asynchronous method. A detailed explanation is given in my earlier video where we have described a sequential circuit with examples. So there we have covered the counters with asynchronous design as well as the synchronous design. So let us today we are going to write a synchronous 4-bit counter using a sequential statements. 4-bit counter using a sequential statement. So when we say a 4-bit counter, so the output of that 4-bit counter, it starts from logic 0000, and if it is a counter, by step 1 increase, the next step of the counter is 0001, then 010, and it goes on repeating up to 1111. Okay, so 0 to 111 it repeats, and immediately after that, after adding 1 into that, the next value goes to 000. So like that we have to design a 4-bit up counter. So to design a 4-bit up counter, what are the inputs and output we need to declare? So in this diagram we can see here, we need to, because of this is a sequential circuit, we are considering as a clock input. Yes, so on each rising edge of the clock we are incrementing the counter, on each rising edge of the clock we are incrementing the counter, as well as now this count we are taking as a directly out, but to increment a counter we need one internal signal. So that internal signal, a 4-bit internal signal, we are declaring as a temp. This temp we are going to increase internally, and this temp value we are going to assign to the count. So this is something like our entity declaration for the 4-bit up counter. So let's start writing a VHDL code for a 4-bit up counter. So as usual method, let us start with a file, new project, up counter 4-bit. Okay, I'm giving my project name as a 4-bit up counter. Then the our evaluation board, our development board family is Spartan 3A, device XC3S50, all these things are same only. Finish. Then add the new source file, new source VHDL module. So up counter 4-bit. Okay, up counter 4-bit. Next. So as I said, for a 4-bit up counter, what are the inputs required in the entity? We need only clock as an input source and a count as a out source, but we are going to design a 4-bit, so make its length as a 3 down to 0. Got it? So clock is input, count is output, 4-bit. Okay, next. Finish. So here library declaration came, but these libraries are not enough for the counter, but we'll see, and after showing the error we are going to add here library. So let's start entity declaration. It is clock in std underscore logic data type count out with a bus width of 4-bit. Then end entity name, architecture, behavioral of entity name is, then here internal signal. So as I said, internal signal we are going to declare as a temp. So let us see how to declare an internal signal between architecture and begin. So we have to start with the keyword signal temp. Temporary signal we are taking and having a width of bus std underscore logic underscore vector, and this we are assigning a initial value to 0000. Okay, so we are starting our counter 3 down to 0. Okay, so a temporary signal we have taken, it is a 4-bit signal, and this temporary we are going to increment it by step of logic 1, and its initial value, this is the initial value assignment. Okay, So let's begin. So we are going to design a counter using a process statement because counter is a sequential circuit. So let's start process. So what are the sensitive list signals of my process? It is a clock. This is the input. So then begin now. Now we have said it on each rising edge of the clock, on each rising edge of the clock, my counter goes, it has to be increased. So first of all, we have to detect the clock. So if clock tick event and clock equal to 1, I think this I have explained in much better way while designing the flip-flop. Still, I will explain here again. What is the meaning of clock tick event? Clock tick event means it is checking the event on the clock signal. So clock signal is a single bit. So there are possibilities of changing its logic from 0 to 1. 0 to 1 means it is rising edge. Or there is another one possibility of changing logic from 1 to 0. So the event, clock tick event is an aggregate in the VHDL. It detects the change on that signal. So here our signal name is clock. So it will detect either the change from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0. Okay. So this concept is clear. Now, and we are doing this tick event and with clock is equal to 1. That means we have to search or we have to detect a tick event or clock event where changes happen, and that change, after happening the change, we have to maintain clock is equal to 1. Clock is equal to 1. So this is how it is detecting. It is 0 to 1 is a change, and we have to detect where clock is equal to 1. That means it is the rising edge detection. So this is rising edge detection. Okay. So this statement detects your rising edge of the clock. After this, on every rising edge, we have to increment the counter. So I am writing temp signal assignment temp plus 1. Temp is equal to temp plus 1. Now here end if. Now after end if temp is incremented inside the process itself, we are going to write count is equal to temp. So here this we are going to, this is our 4 bit counter, okay, and this 4 bit counter temporary, okay, 4 bit counter, we are incrementing it by a step of 1. Okay, so internally, why? Because this count we have declared as out. Why we are not taking here count? Otherwise we need to declare count as a in out. So that's what we have taken internal signal. So internal signal can be act as in, can be act as a out. That is the reason we have taken this temp as an internal signal and we are incrementing it. And then finally, this temp value is assigning to the count value. Temp value is assigned to the count value. Okay. Now just save it. And now if you see, after saving, let us save it. It will give an error. Let us give him error. So plus cannot have such a operand in this context. Okay. So whatever the plus we have used here, we need to declare an additional library. So let us go back here and declare one library called use IEEE dot std underscore logic underscore arith dot all, or we have to, okay. So let us see after adding this, what changes will it will happen. Okay, still it is giving an error, plus cannot have such a operand in this context. So I think another one library we need to add it. So let's add another one package, not a library. It's a package called unsigned.all. So let's check it. So in our earlier lecture here, we have seen the VHDL data types, a predefined VHDL data types. There we have understood various predefined data types or packages in the VHDL, like standard, then standard underscore logic 1164 package. Similarly, there is another one package, std underscore logic underscore unsigned, that is mainly used when we have to do such a addition, when we want to do the mathematical addition. Now it is check syntax is okay, then synthesize it. Yeah, it's taking little bit time. View RTL schematic, start from store. So this generates exactly the block what we are expecting, and it is generating a counter. Okay, so let's see the simulation of this up counter. So let's begin. So assign the clock, force clock. Let us start with 0 in trailing edge logic 1 with 100 nanosecond. Apply, okay. Then we have to just assign this much and we have to keep running the our code. So here we have to make it as 100 nanosecond and run it. Okay. So on each rising edge, if you see on each rising edge, counter value increments. So better I will change it here. Okay. One more thing I will like to explain you. If you observe here, increment is happen on the temp signal. Yes, increment happen on the temp signal, but assignment of that temp is assigned to the count of after the next clock edge. So that is because of the signal assignment. That is because of the signal assignment. But if you declared temp as a variable, that will change. So we are going to do that exercise now itself so you can understand this difference. So try to understand. On each rising edge, temp is incremented by 1, but assignment is happen by a clock delay, or on the next change, or we can say at the end of the process, the assignment happen. So process statement, you know how process statement works. So assignment will happen. See, this temp has incremented immediately on the rising edge of the clock, but this assignment happen at the end of the process. So this count signal assignment happen at the end of the process. So on the rising edge of the clock, temp is incremented, but assignment happen at the end of the process. So let's see, I will change to unsigned decimal. Now you can observe it here in better way. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, then 0. Got it? So this keep on going. Okay. So what I will do now, I will change a program for the, instead of declaring as a temp signal, let us declare it as a, but here, yeah, okay. Declare as a variable and let's check the difference. Variable, okay, save it, behavioral check syntax. Sorry, it will give definitely an error. So simulate the behavioral model. So just wait for some time, it's running. Okay, it's opening. Okay, then okay, so here we have declared, now here we have declared temp as a variable. So because of temp has assigned a variable, it immediately increments your counter value and that value is assigned to the count. So that's what we are going to see, a difference between signal and variable. So let's check it. Now reset it. Now assign clock, right click, force clock, start with 0, 1, with 100 nanosecond. Here also we have to make it 100 nanosecond and run it. Okay, so let's observe it very carefully. Now in earlier example where we have declared a temp as a signal, in that case the count value, the temp value was incremented on this rising edge, but the assignment happened on the next edge. You got it? So if you recall the previous simulation, The temp value incremented on rising edge of the clock, but assignment of the temp to the count happen on the next at the end of the process. But here, temp is executed immediately. It assigns incremented value immediately to temp itself, and that is immediately assigned to the process on the rising edge of the count. So that is the difference. Just I wanted to explain you on each rising edge. Now counter value is incrementing. Okay. So that is the difference between the signal and variable. Signal and the variable. So it keep on changing. So over 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 0. So like this, we can design an up counter using VSTL. So I hope you understood this design using VSTL. So in next lecture, we are going to see a down counter. Okay. So keep watching the video. Thank you.